Anybody from Hungary here today? Fantastic. And you like me still? That is really a reassurance, because there's something going on in Hungary now that is not so nice. It's getting very personal, and it is not personal, or maybe it is. I mean, I guess for you, the issue around democracy, fundamental rights, and rule of law in Hungary is super personal. And for me, it is as well, because what am I there for in the European Parliament? To fight for people's rights, your individual rights to be treated equally, to have fair trial, to actually read newspapers that give you news, not propaganda. And I'm very happy to see that colleagues in the European Parliament, from left to right, of the 28 member states, finally dared to vote in favor of the report that I did, that asks for sanctions against the Hungarian government. And it made me so happy to see one and a half weeks already in Strasbourg that colleagues from the European People's Party said, this is too much, this is going too far. He's not taking anything back. He's only going fast forward since the elections in April in Hungary, where he again had a two-third majority. And they stepped over this party politics and this power play, and they voted in favor of the report, giving an enormous success, a two-third majority. And I think it lifts spirits. I do hope it has lifted your spirits, you Hungarians in the audience, and I do hope it inspires those living in Poland and in Romania and in Slovakia and in Malta, in the last two countries. Journalists were murdered for investigating corruption with involvement of the state. I hope it lifts people's spirits. And it makes you active in protesting against these kind of undemocratic behavior. But I need something there, because this was an important step, but it's not enough. We need the member states to get into action now. We need to get the issue of democracy and rule of law and fundamental rights on the agenda of the European Council. And I need you to act for that. I need you to talk to or address Macron and Merkel and Premier Michel and my own Prime Minister Rutte, because they cannot, as they have done since 2010, think this will pass. When we have European elections in May 2019 and nothing has changed in between, what will citizens think in Romania that went on the streets this summer to demonstrate against corruption and in favor of rule of law? What will those colleagues in Poland say when they take more inspiration for what's happening in Hungary, when they change the NGO law, or when they start, friends of the government are starting buying up newspapers to make sure that there is only one sort of news addressed the citizens? So there you go. Please, when you come home, find the address, the email address or the Facebook page of your Prime Minister, and send him or her an email, or address them differently and say, when are you going to talk about Hungary in the Council, and when can we expect action in order for Hungary to return back to the family of democratic countries? Because what is this about? This is about individual rights of European citizens, all European citizens, and Hungarians especially, because they are not secondary citizens. They have similar rights like all of you. That means fair elections, independent media, equality between men and women, respect for minorities, and all those European values that we fight for and that we fought for so long. Thank you very much.